Hello friends, in this video we are starting with Laplace transform type number 1, that is basic problems, and we solving the first 4 problems. Welcome back students, let's move on and let's discuss type 1 of Laplace transform, that is basic problems. So here in this particular type we gonna see the basic problems of Laplace transform in the first 4 problems that we're going to discuss in this particular video. We'll see how to use these formulas. As we move on, the difficulty level will increase. So let's begin. So here friends, first of all, let me tell you 2 properties that is very important. The first property is linearity property. No need to remember the name. See what the property says. Suppose, let me remove this because I don't want you to confuse you with the names. Just see what is the use. Suppose 2 functions are separated by plus or minus. Suppose 2 functions are separated with plus or minus. You can simply separate it and you can write it down as Laplace of f1t plus minus Laplace of f2t. So 2 functions separated by plus or minus, you can write it down like this. Next. Suppose in between 2 functions you have multiplication. In between 2 functions, suppose you have multiplication, so you cannot separate. So this simply can't be written as Laplace of f1t dot Laplace of f2t. So these are the important things that you need to remember, because as you move on, these small things will make your life difficult. So just remember the basic things. If it is plus or minus between 2 terms, you can separate Laplace transform. Whereas if it is multiplication, you can't separate. And the third thing is, if you have a constant inside Laplace transform, you can take this constant outside. So these are the 3 properties that you need to remember. Constant will come out and Laplace of f of t. So these are the 3 properties. So along with this 10 formulas, these 3 properties you need to remember. Okay, so let's revise these properties quickly, these formulas quickly. Let me have a rapid fire round with you. Let me check, did you understand these formulas or not? Start. E raised to 2t, what is Laplace of e raised to 2t? Check the formula and tell me. See here, 1 upon s minus 2. If it is plus a, we're gonna write it on minus a. So e raised to 2t. So plus 2, we're gonna write it on minus 2. Next, sine 2t. See here. If it is sine at, a upon s square plus a square. Sine 2t means 2 upon s square plus 4. Next. Let's say t raised to 4. 4 factorial upon s raised to 5. So this is the way we're gonna use the formula. So let's move on and let's start solving the problem. Problem number 1. I'm going to rub these things whenever required. So let's move on with the first problem. Since f of t is equal to whatever is the given function, I am going to consider it as f of t. Take lt, that means Laplace transform. So if you take Laplace transform, this will be Laplace of f of t, which is equal to Laplace of 2 raised to t plus e raised to 2t plus sine 3t. So if you see here, all the terms are separated by plus, and as we discussed, if the terms are separated by plus or minus, you can simply separate Laplace transform. The same thing will apply here. So it will be separated. So this will be Laplace of 2 raised to t, e raised to 2t, Laplace of sine 3t. What is Laplace of 2 raised to 2t? See here, you can compare this with this. So here it is 2 raised to t. For a raised to t, we have 1 upon s minus log a. So if it is 2 raised to t, it will be 1 upon s minus log 2 plus 1 upon plus 2, then we're going to write down minus 2 plus sine 3t. So it's simply a upon s square plus a square. A is here. So instead of a, we do have 3. So it will be 3 upon s square plus 9. So this is Laplace of f of t. Done with the first problem. Let us move on. Let us discuss the next example, number 2. In question number 2, f of t is sine 2t minus cos 2t the whole square. So this is the next example. So how we gonna do this? Let me remove this. I hope you have copied this. So let us move on. And this is sine 2t minus cos 2t. So what we gonna do here? Take Lt. So this will become Laplace of f of t is equal to Laplace of sine 2t minus cos 2t the whole square. The question is, can you separate here? Yes or no? No. Why not? Because there is multiplication in between. I agree, but there is square also. If suppose there is no square, at that time you can simply open the brackets. There is no issue. But since it is square, first of all you need to evaluate this. You need to solve this first, and then you can separate. So the whole square. What is the formula? A minus b the whole square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. See friends, you have the facility of video. So I am discussing the formulas with you. Whenever you find you don't know the formula, pause the video and you can write it down somewhere. Okay? So the formula for a minus b the whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. So this will be Laplace of, let's open the bracket, sine 2t minus cos 2t the whole square. So a square means sine square 2t minus twice ab. So it will be 2 sine 2t cos 2t plus b square cos 2t. Cos 2t square is cos square 2t. Cos square 2t. Right? Let us move on and let us discuss the formula that is required here. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So this is the first formula, and the next formula is sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. These are the two formulas that will be required in this particular problem. So if you see these two terms, sine square 2t plus cos square 2t, it will be 1. This is the formula. Let me brief you this formula. Till the time we have sine square, cos square, angle doesn't matter, result is 1. If it is sine square, cos square, angle may be anything, result is 1. For example, sine square 2 theta plus cos square 2 theta, 1. Sine square theta by 2 plus cos square theta by 2, 1. Sine square theta by 4, cos square theta by 4, 1. Angle may be anything, huh? But make sure that you need to remember the angle should be same. So whether it is theta, both theta will okay, both theta by 2 will be okay, both theta by 4 will be okay, the result is 1. So if you know the standard formula, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, and you don't know the variation that we discussed, sine square theta by 2 plus cos square theta by 2 is also 1, sine square theta by 4 plus cos square theta by 4 is equal to 1. So if you know this but don't know the variation, you can copy somewhere, right? And the second formula is sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. This formula is called half angle formula. Here angle becomes half. See here, what is the angle? 2 theta. So if you make 2 theta half, simply divided by 2 in short. So 2 theta, if you divide it by 2 or multiply by 1 by half, so it will be theta. So here it is theta, right? Now in this particular problem, what we have is 2t and 2t. So if it is sine 4t, it will become 2 sine 2t cos 2t. How? Angle becomes half. So this 4t, if you multiply by half, that will become 2t. So this is the way we are going to form this formula. So 4t, angle will become half, 2t, 2t. See here, 2 theta, angle will be half, theta and theta. So these are the formulas. So if you don't know the variation, you can copy. For example, let me give one more example. Suppose it is sine theta by 2. If you apply half angle, so that will become 2 sine theta by 2. If you multiply by 1 by 2, so that will become 1 by 4. So that will become theta by 4 cos theta by 4. So theta by 2 into half is theta by 4 and theta by 4. So these are the variation of the formula. So let's move on. So this will become Laplace of sine square 2t plus cos square 2t is obviously 1 minus, as discussed, 2 sine 2t cos 2t is what? Sine 4t. Now tell me, can we separate here? Yes, now we can separate. Why? Because we converted this into plus or minus. Now you can separate. So this can be written as Laplace of 1 minus Laplace of sine 4t. So that is Laplace of 1 is 1 by s minus Laplace of sine 4t is 4 upon s square plus 16. So if you see here, sine 80, a upon s square plus a square, the same way, 4 upon s square plus 16. So this is problem number 2. So we're done with 1 and 2. Please copy in the same video. We'll be solving 3rd and 4th problem. Problem number 3 is f of t is equal to sine square t. Very simple. Third and fourth problem are very simple. Now, what is the difference here? If you observe the formulas and remember this thing, we can find out Laplace of linear terms only. We can find it out Laplace of linear terms only. If you check this, trigonometric terms here, sine raised to 1, sine raised to 1, see here. So, you can find it out Laplace of linear terms only. Here it is square. So, first of all, we need to convert this square into linear term. So, what is the formula here? It's 1 minus cos 2t upon 2. Let me discuss this variation also with you. In the first problem, in the second problem, we discussed few formulas. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 sin 2 theta, that formula. And here we are going to discuss few more formulas. All the formulas, please copy somewhere. Okay? So, let's discuss the formulas. Suppose you have sine square theta is actually 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2. And if you have cos square theta is actually 1 plus cos 2 theta upon 2. So see the difference here. If it is sine, we have minus. If it is cos, we have plus. This is the first difference. And next, see how to write it down the angle here. See here, with theta what you have? If you observe this carefully, with the theta you have 1, see here, with theta you have 1, so it will be 2 into 1, that is 2, or in short, you just twice the angle. So here with theta we have 1, double the angle, so 2 theta. With theta we have 1, double the angle, see here, if you have sine square 2 theta, so what you are going to do, double the angle, so 2 theta, double the angle means multiply by 2, it will be 1 minus cos 4 theta upon 2. And suppose you have, let's say, cos square theta by 2. In sine you need to remember minus, and in cos formula it will be plus. So double the angle. So this will be 1 plus, here it is theta by 2. So theta by 2 multiplied by 2. So is what, theta only. So this one is cos theta upon 2. Hope this is clear. So suppose, well, let's see one more example. Let's say cos square theta by 4. So what you gonna do? Theta by 4 multiplied by 2. So that will become theta by 2. So this will be 1 plus cos theta by 2 upon 2. So I've shown you how to write it down these formulas. So remember this format and make a note somewhere. Okay. So this is the case. Now take LT. So if you take LT, this will be Laplace of f of t is equal to Laplace of sine square t. But sine square t got converted into this term. That is 1 minus cos 2t upon 2, right? Now what next? It's very simple. You know, if there is a constant inside Laplace transform, that will come out. Laplace of a f of t, a will come out, and Laplace of f of t, right? The same way here, 1 upon 2, this 1 upon 2 is a constant, that will come out, and you will be left with Laplace of 1 minus cos 2t. What next? Now you can separate, because there is plus or minus in between. So it will be half, and you can separate Laplace of 1, Laplace of cos 2t. So Laplace of 1 is 1 by s, so here it will be 1 by s minus Laplace of cos 2t. Laplace of cos 2t is s upon s square plus a square, so this will be s upon s square plus 4. So this is the Laplace of sine square t. Let's move on with the next example. F of t is equal to cos square t. So take LT, that is Laplace transform. Tell me how to do it. Ideally, you should pause this video and try solving the problem by yourself. Tell me what to do. Sine square, you already done with it. In cos square, what is the difference? Only formula difference. In sine it is minus, in cos it is plus. What will happen? This cos square t, you're gonna write it down as 1 plus cos 2t upon 2, right? 1 upon 2 outside, Laplace of 1 plus cos 2t. So Laplace of 1 is 1 by s, and cos 2t is s upon s square plus 4. So let's do it. So this is Laplace of cos square t, you are going to write it down as 1 plus cos 2t upon 2. So we're going to take 1 upon 2 outside, and you will be left with the Laplace of 1 plus cos 2t. So you got two terms in plus or minus. So you can take Laplace inside. So Laplace of 1, 1 by s plus Laplace of cos 2t, s upon s square plus 4. So we got the solution of f of t cos square t. Done with 4 problems. Hope you understood. Practice well. In the next videos, we'll move on. Difficulty level will increase. Hope you'll get it. Thank you.